Merchant of Venice, Act 3, Scene 2, second recording. This is the continuation of the last part. Bassanio says, "Confess and love has been the very sum of my confession. Oh, happy torment, when my torturer doth teach me the answers for deliverance, but let me to my fortune and the cascades." We had completed till this in the last class. We'll start from here. Now, what does Portia say in this long speech? She says that her portrait was locked in one of the caskets. If Bassanio loved her truly, he would definitely find the right casket. Away then, I am locked in one of the caskets. My portrait is locked in one of the caskets. If you love me truly, you will find me out. There's a reference to Act 1, Scene 2, when Portia was sad, and Nerissa assures her that the right casket cannot be chosen by any person randomly, but only the person who truly loves her. So she believes in this and she says that, if you truly love me, you will find me out. Nerissa and others stand away, stand at a distance, and let music be played while he does make his choice. So that if he loses, his loss or end could be compared to the death of a swan. The Elizabethans believed that the swan sings only once before it dies. So there was a myth that a swan sings only once before it dies and it drowns in the stream, pond or the river. So if Bassanio chooses the wrong casket, his hopes will end. So his loss, his end could be compared to the swan's end. Here, Bassanio is like the swan. She asks the music to be played. Music will be like swan's last song. And the comparison may stand more proper. To make the comparison appropriate and complete, my eyes shall be the stream. So swan drowns in the stream or pond. Here, Portia's tears will play the role of pond or stream. And watery deathbed for him. So watery grave. So my tears will be like the watery grave, just where the swan drowns. Similarly, Bassanio's hope will drown in my tears. He may win. What is music then? What role will music play if he wins? Then music is like the flourish of trumpets. Flourish matlab blowing of trumpets. At the coronation of a monarch, coronation Raj Tilak, when a prince is crowned as a monarch. Trumpets are blown. Why are trumpets blown? To felicitate the prince, to show regard for the prince. So then the music will play the role of the ceremonial blowing of trumpets at the coronation of a monarch. Even as the flourish when true subjects bow. True subjects means loyal subjects. They bow in honor, they bow in respect to a new crowned monarch. So who is the monarch here? Monarch is Bassanio, if he wins the casket. Crown, Portia. True subjects or loyal followers, Nerissa and others. Blowing of the trumpets, music played. Such it is as are those dulcet sounds, sweet sounds in the break of day, early morning, dawn, that creep into such it is. So such it is matlab, the music played could be compared to or it is similar to the sweet sounds that enter into the ears of the man who is going to be married. Sounds in break of day, dulcet sounds, sweet sounds played at the break of day, dawn, that creep into the dreaming bridegroom's ears, that enter into the ears of the man who is going to be married and summon him to marriage, call him to marriage, call him to attend his marriage. So here we have another reference. This is an allusion to the old English custom of playing music under the windows of the bridegroom's bedroom on the morning of his marriage. So, ek English custom tha ki jis insaan jiska shaadi tha hota tha uske room ke bahar subah subah म्यूजिक, स्वीट म्यूजिक प्ले किया जाता था समनिंग हिम टू मैरिज. एंड म्यूजिक यहाँ पे ये भी है कि जब व्हेन द पर्सन गेट्स अप ही इज फुल ऑफ म्यूजिक, दैट इज ड्रीम्स अबाउट हिज लव लाइफ, ड्रीम्स अबाउट हिज मैरिज. सो द प्लेजेंट इमोशंस दैट इज देयर इन द मैन दैट कुड बी कंपेयर टू द स्वीट साउंड्स. As are those delicate sounds in break of day that creep into, that enter into the dreaming bridegroom's ears, then summon him to marriage. So, Portia asks music to be played and says that music will play two roles. If Bassanio loses, music will make Bassanio's, the end of Bassanio's hope, comparable to the death of a swan which sings a song and drowns in the pond. If Bassanio wins, then music could be compared to the ceremonial blowing of trumpets and the delicate sounds of marriage, sounds which are played outside the man who is getting married, his room, at the dawn of his marriage. Now he goes. Who goes? Bassanio goes. Where does he go? He approaches the casket. With no less presence, how does Bassanio go? Bassanio goes very gracefully. No and less, no is negative term, less is negative term. No and less means with much presence. Presence means grace. So Bassanio's approach of the casket has been compared to be a graceful gesture. Bassanio is approaching the casket more gracefully than Hercules. Now Hercules, where did Hercules approach? Now there's a story. Troy was cursed to be plagued by a sea monster. Troy was cursed to be plagued by a sea monster. However, there was, the curse could be checked, prevented, if Hesione the princess was sent to the sea monster as a sacrifice. That would appease the sea monster and the sea monster would spare the city. So एक सी मॉन्स्टर अटैक करने वाला था, प्लाग करने वाला था, टॉर्चर करने वाला था सिटी ऑफ ट्रॉय को. और इस श्राप से बचने का एक ही तरीका था, प्रिंसेस जो किंग की बेटी थी हेसियोने, उसको भेज दिया जाए सी मॉन्स्टर के पास, ताकि सी मॉन्स्टर काम हो जाए और वो सिटी को प्लाग नहीं करे. बट जब हेसियोने को भेजा गया तो ट्रोजन पीपल हरक्यूलिस को बुलाए और हरक्यूलिस उस सी मॉन्स्टर से लड़ने गया. उस सी मॉन्स्टर को फिश हुक और एरोस से मारा. तो हरक्यूलिस के अप्रोच को, सी मॉन्स्टर से जब वो लड़ने गया, बताया जा रहा है कि बसानियो जब कैस्केट्स को अप्रोच कर रहा है, इट इज़ मोर ग्रेसफुल देन हरक्यूलिस, बिकॉज हरक्यूलिस सी मॉन्स्टर से लड़ा था फॉर रिवॉर्ड, ही वॉन्टेड द किंग्स हॉर्सेज. So Hercules, when he fought the sea monster, he did so because he wanted the king's horses. Whereas Bassanio, he was motivated by love. So any task which is motivated by love is more graceful than the task which is motivated by any material desire or reward. So now Bassanio goes and his approach is more graceful than Hercules because it is full of much more love. Bassanio is approaching the casket motivated by love. So, यहाँ पे सी मॉन्स्टर कौन है? सी मॉन्स्टर है कैस्केट्स. हरक्यूलिस कौन है? बसानियो. हेसियोने प्रिंसेस कौन है? पोर्शिया. और ट्रोजन पीपल कौन है? हाउलिंग पीपल, क्राइंग पीपल ऑफ ट्रॉय कौन है? नरिसा एंड अदर स्टैंडिंग अलूफ विथ नो लेस प्रेजेंस बट विथ मच मोर लव दैन यंग एलसाइड्स. एलसाइड्स इज अनदर नेम ऑफ हरक्यूलिस, प्रिंस ऑफ मोरक्को बताया था. एलसाइड्स प्लेइंग विथ दिस पेज इफ यू रिमेंबर एंड लूजिंग द गेम. So Alcides is another name of Hercules, who was the classical god of strength. When he did redeem, he matlab Hercules, redeem matlab rescued, bachaya, kisko? Hesione. The virgin tribute paid by the howling Troy. Virgin tribute, she was a maiden and she was offered as a sacrifice to the sea monster to appease the sea monster so that the city would not be plagued. The virgin tribute paid by howling Troy. Howling matlab crying out loudly. The people of Troy crying out loudly. So they had gathered by the seashore, and here Nerissa and others have gathered by the away from the casket to the sea monster. So when Hesione was offered to the sea monster, I stand for sacrifice. Similarly, I stand for sacrifice as Hesione was offered as a, to the sea monster. Similarly, I am also standing for sacrifice. The rest aloof are Dardanian wives. Dardanian matlab Trojan women. Dardanian wives matlab Trojan women. Because Dardanius jo tha, he was the mythical founder of Dardania. But Dardania jo hai, wo do city mein divided tha. Dardania aur Troy. तो इसलिए डार्डेनियंस और ट्रोजन्स डिफरेंट थे बट मैनी पीपल दे यूज़ डार्डेनिया एंड ट्रॉय डार्डेनियंस एंड द ट्रोजन्स एज द सेम दे ट्रीट बोथ एज द सेम वी डोंट हैव टू गो इनटू सो मच डिटेल्स हियर यू कैन टेक कंसिडर द डार्डेनियन वाइव्स एज ट्रोजन वुमेन सो हु वेर हाउलिंग हु वेर क्राइंग द ट्रोजन मैन एंड द ट्रोजन वुमेन दे वर क्राइंग विद ब्लियर्ड विसेजेस ब्लियर्ड मतलब painted with tears but painted word theek nahi hai use karna we will use the word smeared with tears smeared so their faces were smeared with tears bleared visages they had come forth matlab gathered who had gathered dardanian wives and trojan men had gathered the howling people of troy and the dardanian men wives had gathered they have come forth to view the issue of the exploit view the outcome of the fight between Hercules and the sea monster. Similarly, here Nerissa and the others have gathered to see the outcome of Bassanio participating in the lottery of the casket. Go Hercules. Now she terms her Bassanio as Hercules. You are my Hercules. Go. Live thou. Matlab, if you choose the right casket, I live. So if your hopes survive, I will survive because her existence would be meaningless without Bassanio. So I will survive only if your hopes survive. With much, much more dismay. Dismay matlab concern, anxiety, worry. I view the fight. I am witnessing this fight than you who is making the fray. Making matlab engaging in this fight. Oh Bassanio, you are engaging in the fight but I am more worried because the outcome is very relevant to me. Music is played while Bassanio comments on the casket to himself. The song says, tell me where is fancy bread. Let us understand the word bread, matlab born. Fanciful, fancy matlab fanciful love. Fanciful love matlab imagination and infatuation. And fanciful love is opposed to true love. Fanciful love kya hota hai? Infatuation hota hai. You fall in love because you find a person attractive. तो अगर किसी को अट्रैक्टिव फाइंड करके इफ़ वी फॉलो इन लव वी फाइंड दैट अट्रैक्शन डजेंट लास्ट फॉर लॉन्ग व्हेन वी फाइंड दैट द पर्सन हैज़ गॉट अदर इल क्वालिटीज लाइक इल टेम्पर्ड बीइंग शॉर्ट टेम्पर्ड बीइंग इरिटेबल देन व्हाट विल हैपन इज द पर्सन हु अपीयर्ड अट्रैक्टिव वुड सीज टू बी सो बोलते हैं ना कि अब तुमको देखना पसंद नहीं करते हैं सो फैंसी जो है वो आइज में बॉर्न होता है फैंसीफुल लव आइज में बॉर्न होता है और फैंसीफुल लव आइज में ही मर जाता है सो टेल मी वेर इज फैंसीफुल लव बॉर्न इज इट बॉर्न इन द हार्ट इज इट बॉर्न इन द हेड ऑल्सो टेल मी हाउ बिगॉट बिगॉट मतलब बॉर्न एंड हाउ नरिश्ड नरिश्ड मतलब हाउ इज इट ब्रॉट अप व्हाट फूड डज इट ईट हाउ इज इट फेड सो क्वेश्चन क्या था वेर इज फैंसीफुल लव बॉर्न एंड वॉट इज द नरिशमेंट ऑफ फैंसीफुल लव रिप्लाई आंसर इट इज एनजेंडर्ड इन द आइज इट मतलब फैंसीफुल लव इट इज बॉर्न इन द आइज With gazing fed, what is the nourishment of fanciful love? Loving glances, mutual gazing of lovers. So, एक दूसरे को देख के वो desire satisfy होता है, एक दूसरे को देख के fanciful love का nourishment मिलता है. मतलब हम एक हमको कोई person पसंद आया, उसको हम बार बार देखना चाहेंगे, जितना देखेंगे हमको वो और पसंद आएगा. But वो एक limit तक वो पसंद आएगा, उसके बाद हम उसको देखना भी पसंद नहीं करेंगे. So, it is fed by the mutual, it grows by mutual gazing of the lovers. But fanciful love dies in the cradle where it lies. Cradle matlab palna. To cradle here stand for infant stage or initial stage. To fanciful love doesn't last for long. It is born in the eyes and it dies in the eyes itself. To yahan pe cradle matlab eyes. To fanciful love eyes mein hi born hota hai and it dies in the eyes itself. Where it lies dead. So where it is born. So jahan pe wo born hota hai, wahin pe wo mar jata hai. Iska matlab kya hua? कि फैंसीफुल लव इज शॉर्ट लास्टिंग लेट अस ऑल रिंग फैंसीज नेल सो लेट अस ऑल रिंग द डेथ बेल ऑफ फैंसी और फैंसीफुल लव नेल मतलब जब ये क्रिश्चियन कस्टम है पहले छोटे विलेजेस होते थे तो उसमें एक चर्च होता था जिसमें मान लो विलेज में खाली 10 फैमिलीज हैं तो उसमें से किसी का डेथ हो गया तो चर्च बेल को बजाया जाता था। अभी तो पॉपुलेशन इतना हो गया कि पॉसिबल नहीं है, चर्च बेल बजते ही रह जाएगा। तो इसीलिए अब ये कस्टम नहीं है, बट पहले क्या होता था कि छोटे छोटे विलेजेस होते थे, 5-6 फैमिलीज होते थे, वहाँ पे किसी का डेथ हो जाता था तो उस पर्सन को ट्रिब्यूट देने के लिए चर्च बेल बजाया जाता था फ्यूनरल सेरेमनी में। तो अभी भी हो सकता है, आई डोंट नो द क्रिश्चियन कस्टम, हो सकता है कि जब ग्रेवयार्ड में बरी करते हैं तो चर्च बेल बजाया जाता होगा, बट वी डोंट नीड टू नो दैट। फैंसीफुल मतलब रिंगिंग द डेथ बेल, सो लेट अस ऑल रिंग फैंसीफुल फैंसीज नेल, आई विल बिगिन इट, डिंग डोंग बेल डिंग डोंग बेल। सो सम रेफरेंसेस हियर, केटोस ट्रोयास, जानने का जरूरत नहीं है, आई मीन इसको सिर्फ जान लो, ट्रोजन सेटस नाम था जायंट सी मॉन्स्टर का। ही वॉज सेंट बाई हुम, वी डोंट नीड टू नो, ही वॉज सेंट टू प्लाग द लैंड ऑफ ट्रॉय, क्यों नहीं जानना है। ओरेकल मतलब भविष्यवाणी, ओरेकल डिक्लेयर्ड दैट द ओनली वे टू बी रिड ऑफ द बीस्ट वॉज टू ऑफर द किंग्स डॉटर एज अ सेक्रीफाइस। सो हाउ, वॉट वॉज द ओनली वे टू गेट रिड ऑफ द सी मॉन्स्टर, दैट वॉज टू ऑफर द किंग्स डॉटर एज अ सेक्रीफाइस। नाउ हेसियोने वॉज चेंज्ड टू द रॉक्स एंड हरक्यूलिस रेस्क्यूड हर बाई किलिंग द सी मॉन्स्टर विद अ फिश हुक और वॉली ऑफ एरोज। सो दिस इज एन इमेज ऑफ हरक्यूलिस फाइटिंग द सी मॉन्स्टर एंड रेस्क्यूइंग हेसियोने। ये है डल्सेट साउंड्स का रेफरेंस एंड अल्यूजन, अल्यूजन मतलब रेफरेंस होता है टू द ओल्ड इंग्लिश कस्टम ऑफ प्लेइंग म्यूजिक अंडर द विंडोज ऑफ द ब्राइडग्रूम्स बेडरूम ऑन द मॉर्निंग ऑफ हिज मैरिज। सो हरक्यूलिस रेस्क्यूड हेसियोने हु वॉज द डॉटर ऑफ द ट्रोजन किंग, अनमैरिड थी इसलिए वर्जिन ट्रिब्यूट ट्रिब्यूट क्योंकि सेक्रीफाइस दिया गया था। ही एक्टेड नॉट फ्रॉम लव बट फ्रॉम डिजायर टू गेट द हॉर्सेज ऑफर्ड एज अ रिवॉर्ड, इसीलिए Bassanio was more graceful because he was motivated by love. So, what are the important things that we learn from today's lesson? The first thing was Portia asking music to be played and comparing the role of music to Bassanio's choosing the right casket and Bassanio's choosing the wrong casket. She says that if Bassanio loses, his comparison would be appropriate compared to a swan-like end. But if Bassanio wins, then it could be compared to the ceremonial blowing of trumpets at the coronation ceremony or the delicate sounds that creep into the dreaming bridegroom's ears. Book cover jitna use karoge utna answer karne mein aasani bhi hoga and you would not have to write long answers. Summary of the part discussed today, Portia. Let us then proceed to the caskets. My picture is locked in one of them. If you love me truly, you would be able to choose the right casket. Let Nerissa and the others stand in a group a little away from the caskets. Let music be played while Bassanio gets ready to make his choice. If he chooses wrong, his end would be similar to that of a swan which sings while dying. Bassanio would then be meeting a safe fate while music would be playing. This comparison between a swan meeting his death and Bassanio's failure in his choice should be regarded as quite appropriate in view of the fact that at the time my eyes would be filled with tears of disappointment, and those tears would thus serve as a stream in which Bassanio, like a swan, would meet his end. But there is also the possibility that Bassanio may choose the right casket. What purpose would music serve in that case? Well, in that case, music would serve the same purpose as the blowing of trumpets does when loyal subjects bend humbly and respectfully to a king at the time of his coronation, or would then be like those sweet sounds which are heard faintly at dawn by the dreaming man who is to be married that day and which arouse him from his dreams so that he may get ready for the marriage. Seeing Bassanio walk towards the caskets, now Bassanio goes towards the caskets with no less dignity but with greater love than young Hercules when that ancient hero went forward and saved the life of the maiden Hesione, who was being offered as a sacrifice to appease a sea monster. The girl was being offered as a sacrifice by the people of Troy, who were at the time weeping aloud in their distress. But Hercules was able to save the maiden by killing the sea monster. I may be compared to the maiden who was being offered as a sacrifice, while the others who stand apart in a group may be compared to the Trojan wives who had gone with tearful faces to watch the outcome of the fight between Hercules and the sea monster. Bassanio may be compared to Hercules, then addressing Bassanio. If you succeed in making the right choice, my life would be saved. I am now waiting for the result with greater fear than you who are about to undergo the test. A song is sung by some musicians to the accompaniment of musical instruments, while Bassanio speaks aloud to himself with regard to the comparative merits of the casket. The song is as follows. Tell me the origin of the feeling of love. Does love have its origin in the heart of a human being or in the head of a human being? We find that heart, true love is born in the heart. How is love produced and how is it fed? Give answer to these questions. The song continues thus. Love is born in the eyes and it is nourished by the mutual gazing of the lovers at each other. The feeling of love, if it is a mere fancy and not something real, would die in its very initial stages. The fanciful kind of love soon ends and it can be seen lying dead. Let us all join to ring the death bell of this kind of love. I will begin the process. Let us ring the death bell. Yes, let the death bell be rung of such love be rung. I will provide you the PDF of the material used in this video. Thank you so much for attending.